wonder how three kids from Brooklyn got their hands on a time-traveling book? Well, it all started on this beach, right around my birthday. See, Sam and Fred and I were... Oh, wait, here we come now.
When did we decide to climb a tree? Weren't we just in Joe's kitchen?
Okay, nobody panic. One of us is obviously having a dream. All we have to do is figure out which one, then pound him until he wakes up.
What was that?
Haul in your sails now and listen to me, and give us the time to blow the man down.
Who is that?
8, 9, 10. Dig here, lads. We bury our treasure, and we three be the only ones what know about it, eh?
Aye, aye, Captain Blackbeard.
Blackbeard? As in Blackbeard the pirate?
Didn't he die like 300 years ago? Come on, that's an actor. This must be some kind of pirate theme park. If this is a theme park, it's got the worst rides I've ever seen.
Sorry, mates, but now I be the only one what knows where the treasure's buried.
It really is Blackbeard, the craziest, meanest pirate of all time. But that means
it's nearly 300 years ago.
Hey!
Hey! A couple of wharf rats are spying on me.
No!
Be careful what you wish for.
Blackbeard pulls the trigger. Maybe I should finish explaining how three kids from Brooklyn ended up facing a pirate with a bad attitude. It all started on my birthday.
Hold it.
Busted.
Aw, Mom, it's my birthday.
After dinner.
That's how it starts. One day it's stealing frosting, the next robbing piggy banks.
It's very tragic. Who needs piggy banks? I've got friends with quarters for brains.
I'll get it.
Salam and falafel, nephew.
Uncle Joe!
I wish to mark the anniversary of your propitious appearance on this planet, Joseph. Now, where did I put the... here it is. As they say in Madagascar, happy birthday!
Thanks. At least come in and have some cake. Hey, Mom, look who's here. Uncle Joe, Huh?
Who was that?
It was Uncle Joe, but he just... disappeared.
Really? Is that for you?
Yeah. Should I wait to open it?
No need. Enjoy.
Well, come on, open it. Your uncle's a magician. It's gotta be something cool. Happy birthday, magician in training. Be careful what you wish for. You might just get it.
The book? Catchy title.
Nice pictures.
Hey, a pirate ship. Treasure. Now you're talking. Man, I wish I was a pirate. No school, sailing the 17 seas, digging for buried treasure.
Hey, what's going on?
So that's how we found ourselves staring down the barrels of Blackbeard's pistols and really hoping that pine cones are bulletproof.
Ah, job, Barnacles. Forgot to reload. But ye spies won't be going nowhere, will ye now?
Wait, wait! Oh, we're not spies! We can explain!
1, 2, 3! Ha ha ha! The trees be full of monkeys today!
Look, Mr. Blackbeard, sir, we're not even slightly spies. We're from the future.
Hot air and bilge water. Say your prayers, boys.
No, no, wait, wait. I can prove we're from the future. Your real name is Edward Teach.
And just how do you come to be knowing that, laddie?
Social studies? I know lots of stuff about you. Like you served on a British privateer during the War of the Spanish Succession, and you've got 14 wives.
Hush! Keep your voice down, will ye? All right. Which one sent you to spy on me? Matilda? Annie? Oh, I know. It's what's her name? The little chunky one. I keep telling her, a relationship is built on trust.
No, no, it's like I said, we're from the future.
We're also, magicians. Magicians from a faraway land. Show the man what you can do, Joe.
What? Oh, right. Hey, what's that in your boot?
What? Say, that weren't in me boot before. You mean you lads can pull pieces I ate right out of the air?
Yeah, in fact, we're kinda late for our next gig, so if you don't mind, we'll just...
Lads, I could use a few mates with your talents. How would you like to join the crew aboard me ship? The Queen Anne's Revenge.
Join you? You know, we'd like to really, but... It's against Union rules.
We'd love to!
Yo-ho, and up she rises. Yo-ho, and up she rises. Yo-ho, and up she rises early in the morning.
All I remember is we were in my kitchen looking at the book, at those treasure pictures, and then, zap, we end up being kidnapped by a tone-deaf pirate. The book must be some kind of time-warping thing. So how do we get out of here? Well, the book brought us, so it must be able to get us home.
Great! Except...
where is it? Right. For all we know, it's still in my kitchen.
Ahoy, ye scurvy sea dogs! Drop the ladder! No! Heads up, lads.
Did you see that?
They made him walk the plank.
Pirates don't make you walk planks except in movies. They just throw you overboard.
Oi!
This can't be the Rothstein Bar Mitzvah. Wrong ship. Sorry. Bye.
Israel. Israel Hands. You low-life fish bait son of a wharf rat.
You bellowed, Captain.
Why's that prisoner at the bottom of the briny deep?
I was just having a bit of fun, is all. Playing spin the prisoner.
Prisoners are for ransom. That one would have brought a tidy sum. And where exactly do you expect to find our next treasure, eh? I'll tell ye where we'll find treasure. Right there.
Huh?
Show 'em your magic, laddie. Pull some doubloons out of the air.
Doubloons? Hey, go ahead. Do the coin trick. I can't. Blackbeard's got my only quarter. Here, try this. Used gum? Aw, Fred.
Well, lads, the crew's getting a mite impatient.
You know, coin tricks are overrated. Wouldn't you rather see me make a bunny out of a hanky?
Joe, does this look like a bunny out of a hanky crowd?
Let's see some real magic. Let's see if they can outswim the sharks. Who's in favor?
Aye.
No way you're making me fish food.
Captain Blackbeard, sir, you can't just throw innocent people overboard.
Sorry, lad. Those are pirate rules. Show us your magic. It's over the side with ye.
All right, move on.
Damn it! I thought you said they didn't use planks.
We don't. We heard you talking about it and thought it was a good idea. Now start walking.
British warship off the starboard, Captain.
Mr. Hunt, give me the Brigham near. Looks like we're in for a fight, boys. Hoist anchor, Mr. Hunt. Load cannon and raise the red. Bosun, set the mainsail. We'll outrun her and make a break for open water.
Drop the dead man. Hoist top, main and royal.
Load and tackle battery, port and starboard.
Look alive, ye swarthy sea rats. Wet blankets on the gunpowder. You want to blow my whole ship to kingdom come?
Now what? If the British sink the ship, we're dead. And if Blackbeard makes it to safety, we're dead.
The number three cannon! It's aimed for the gunpowder magazine!
No!
The whole ship's gonna blow! We gotta turn that cannon around!
No!
Well, don't bother to thank us or anything just because we saved your ugly butts.
Fred, we also blew up their mainmast.
So?
So, the British are catching up and now they can't escape.
Oh.
Gangway!
Open this door, ye bellious barnacle. If I'm going down, you're going with me.
Anybody got any ideas?
Maybe we could appeal to his good side?
Good side? The man drinks gunpowder in his rum.
Hey, look at all these books. You don't suppose...
Of course. Maybe Blackbeard found your book and stole it. It is covered in gold and silver.
Start searching. That book is our only way out.
Ye scabby sea slugs.
Attack, men!
Curse ye!
Attack!
Bring her on,
charts. There must be some kind
Hey, how about this? Do I look cool or what?
Forget the souvenirs. Find the book. We've only got... Hey, you hear that?
I don't hear anything.
Exactly.
Touch me.
You can't fit me.
Come on, get up.
All right, you dogs. It's off to the gallows with the lot of you.
Boy, are we glad to see you!
You three! What are you doing in the captain's cabin? Are you part of this mongrel crew?
No way! Oh, you mean because of the hat?
No, please don't hurt us, Captain. We're sorry we lost the fight. Oh.
What?
Please, sirs. We'll try to be better pirates. Just don't whip us.
Whoa. Wait a minute. What are you guys pulling?
Are you trying to say that you've been taking orders from these three?
And I suppose he never heard of the terrible Tripoli trio, the scourge of the Barbary Coast, youngest and fiercest pirates on the Spanish Main.
Hey, that's a load of...
Oh, please, sirs, no more violence. Don't make us walk the plank.
Walk the plank? Well, write that down, Hendrix. It's a splendid idea.
Look! These guys are lying through their rotten teeth!
Well, I don't know. Perhaps this bears further investigation.
Begging your pardon, Your Worship, but if you're looking for testimony against these three, maybe we can work out a little deal. And of course, there'd be something in it for yourself.
Arrest those boys!
And that's how we found ourselves sitting in the prisoner's dock of a colonial courtroom, facing a very different pirate.
I swear on me mother's grave, Your Lordship. We was held captive by the terrible Tripoli Trio and forced into a life of crime and evil doing.
Do you believe this guy?
Oh, 'twas a terrifying ordeal, to be sure. Even now I shudders to think of it.
Yeah, do you need a hanky?
Oh, thank you, sir. Sometimes I get so overcome, you know. I'm just a poor, honest working man trying to support me wife and kiddies.
How noble! Is Mrs. Teach here?
Oh, yeah, of course, and me sisters, too.
If it please the court, I wish to point out that Mr. Teach is now a respectable North Carolina businessman with a full pardon for his crimes from Governor Eden.
Yeah, what did that cost him?
Thank you, Mr. Teach. That will be all.
Sorry, lads. That's the way it goes. Oh, here's your doubloon back. None of the tavern keepers will take it. Oh, no charge for the hat.
Your lordships, you've heard the evidence from Mr. Teach and the rest of his fine crew. For the crime of piracy on the high seas, the province of North Carolina demands the ultimate penalty for these three miscreants. The hangman's noose!
Maybe they're just building a new schoolhouse.
Sure. And those are the swings for the playground. Well, I'm not getting hanged on an empty stomach. Jailer! Hey, jailer!
What do you three pests want?
We're starved. We want our last meal.
Oh, well, of course, Your Majesties. Let's see your money.
Money? We have to pay for our food?
All prisoners pay for their grub. That's the law.
So be it, my good man. Bring us the best meal money can buy. We'll gladly pay.
Oh, yeah? With what?
With this.
Huh? Where did that come from?
Where we live? Everyone carries money in their head.
Hey, show me how you did that.
Well, I guess I could, but you'd have to come in here.
All right. But don't try anything.
Okay, now just do what I do.
When do we get the money? I don't feel no coin.
Dig deeper, I can hear them.
It ain't working.
Try it with both ears. That's it.
What?
I said, never mind.
Come back here.
Thanks for lunch.
This way.
Guys, wait up.
Forget the hat, come on.
Hey, what's this?
Looks like that island we were on. This must be a map to Blackbeard's treasure.
All right, we found a real treasure map.
Yeah, well, if we don't get out of here, we're gonna be too dead to use it. Sam's right. Anyway, we have to find the book.
And how are we gonna do that? We don't even know where to look. Besides, if we can't get home right away, we're gonna need money to get around, right? Well, here's a pile of it, and it's just a mile offshore.
He's got a point. Let's go.
Are you sure this is right? I thought he buried it over there.
It's right according to the map. Maybe he's got more than one treasure on this island. Let's hope this one doesn't have any bodies.
We hit something. Bingo!
You can stop right there, lads.
Blackbeard!
So, he was hoping to steal me treasure.
and after all I done for ye.
Excuse me? You mean nearly getting us drowned, shot at, exploded, and hanged?
Well, if you're gonna get touchy about every little thing. It's too bad, really. You lads have spirit, but business is business. Go ahead, open it. Might as well get a look at a real pirate's treasure, since it's the last thing you'll ever see.
Wow!
Now say your prayers, boys.
Wait, Mr. Blackbeard, sir? As long as we're about to, you know, die, do you think we could actually touch some of the treasure?
Make it quick.
Oh, man!
The book!
Handsome piece of goods, ain't it? Got it off a Spanish scalper. In fact, it was right before I met you lads. Pity you won't have time to read it. Now, prepare to meet Jamaica.
Guys, we're home!
Awesome!
Oh, right! Wow. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, man, I had that treasure right in my hands. What good is fighting pirates if you can't even keep the money?
I guess that book really is some kind of time machine.
Yeah, well, I say we put it somewhere safe and never open it again.
Better clean that up, guys. Interesting book, huh?
And now, the Time Warp Trio presents Real Moments from Real History.
Here's today's Daily Warper. Blackbeard's flag. Hey, did you know that not all pirates flew the skull and crossbones? Most of them had their own flag. Blackbeard's flag was pretty weird. It had a devil's skeleton holding an hourglass and an arrow pointing at a bleeding heart. But the flag you really didn't want to see was red. It pretty much meant you were a goner. In the end, though, it was Blackbeard who was the goner. He was only able to stay straight for about 6 months. He went back to being a pirate, and in November 1718, he was captured and beheaded. His body was thrown overboard. Ah! But some people swear that it swam around the ship a few times before sinking. Arr! If you want to know more strange stuff about Blackbeard, just check out the Time Warp Trio website.